Hi guys, Matt here. Welcome back to Walk Wild. I hope you enjoyed those clips which showed me hiking up the Crib Goch ascent of Mount Snowdon. In this video, I'm going to be telling you how you can hike this very same mountain using this same ridge. I myself just got back from a 5-day trip to Snowdonia National Park where I did this hike. We had an incredible weekend. There was lots of strange weather for May. There was snow, there was hail, there was sleet. It was all very typical Snowdonia, but we got out there, did lots of scrambling and hiking and even some rock climbing. So I'm excited to share that with you guys in this video today. I also want to say a big thank you to Art of the Trek, who are sponsoring this video. I'm really excited for them to sponsor this because they are, like me, wanting to encourage others to do hiking and outdoor adventures, and we're working in the same space. So it's great to have their support for this video, and I'm going to tell you a bit more about them later on in the video. So firstly, where to start with Crib Goch? So Crib Goch is called the Red Ridge. That's what it means in Welsh, and this is because of the reddy brown scree slopes that go down either side of the ridge. It's probably the most famous ridge hike in the whole of the UK, other than maybe Striding Edge, which is in the Lake District. How it forms is that two glaciers come up against each other, and this happened between 11 and 18,000 years ago in Snowdonia National Park, and they rub away to form this arête, is what it's called, this sharp ridge line, and then that leads right up to the top of the summit of Mount Snowdon, basically. So what you get is you get this fantastic exposed scramble slash hike along the ridge leading right up to the tallest mountain of Mount Snowdon, which is 1,085 meters high. Crib Goch is pretty high itself and is 923 meters high, so you've got a bit of a big challenge on you, but it is the most sublime hike, and the views from all around you on the ridge are absolutely stunning. The Crib Goch hike is a grade 1 scramble, so it's not just your average hike. You actually need to be getting on hands and knees at points, and you need to be scrambling up scree slopes and over rock, and it's really quite challenging. So it's not just a standard walk up along a trail, no problems. It's a bit different from that. Grade 1 is the easiest kind of scramble, but I wouldn't say this is an easy hike. I'd say it's actually a very challenging and difficult hike, but that's one of the most rewarding and exciting things about it. Big thank you to Art of the Trek for sponsoring this video. They're working hard to add water sources, campsites, scenic locations, and trailheads to their interactive public map. The good news is that you can add these yourself. If you go over to artofthetrek.com, you can then search for your favorite hiking area and you can add your own points of interest. All you need to do is click on the overlays menu, then click on the orange plus sign and fill in the options, giving more details and photos, which can help out your fellow hikers on their own adventures. The great news is that if you add 12 of these, then Art of the Trek will be happy to send you your very own swag bag. Next, I'm gonna tell you how to get there. Snowdonia is a national park right up in the north of Wales. So if you want to be getting there, you need to be looking at going to maybe somewhere like Bangor, which is a city just to the north of Snowdonia, which is what I did. And to actually get to the hike of Crib Goch, you want to be going to the Penny Pass car park, because there are a few different ways you can climb up Snowdonia. There are actually 6 in total, but there may be even more, but those are the sort of official hikes. And the Penny Pass car park is the home of the Miners Trail and the Pig Trail, as well as Crib Goch. So 3 of the scents can go from that car park. It's a pretty difficult car park to get into because it's very small. So you have to book 24 hours in advance, and it's £18 for the day, which is relatively expensive. Unfortunately for me, I got there and didn't know this. So I ended up driving down the road to a car park, which was £4 for the day, admittedly, which was good, but it only accepts cash, so don't forget to bring cash. But that did mean I added on 1.5 kilometers to get to the start of the trail. So I added on 3 kilometers in total. So it's completely up to you, but maybe it's good to book in advance if you are going to Penny Pass, otherwise they won't let you in. It's pretty simple. And once you get there, there's a visitor center, cafe, toilets, and you need to follow the pig track. It's very clearly signposted, not the miners trail. Those are the two trails that leave from this car park. You follow the pig track up a little bit, and then you will get to the Crib Goch signpost. There are also some buses that can get you to the Penny Pass car park. The S2 and S4 buses can be used, and this is part of the Sherpa bus service, which basically just links up all the hiking trails around Mount Snowdon. So it's pretty easy to get to if you're taking the bus as well, but it does take longer than if you're just driving. So next I'm gonna tell you how do you find your way around this Crib Goch hike. So as I started saying, you will follow the pig track at the start, and then you'll see a stone sign, which will point right up this steep ridge, and that says Cribgoch. And that's the first scramble. You know, this is actually one of the hardest bits of the hike, and it's called the bad step. And there's pretty good reason for that, because it's a bit of a shock to the system when you first start, because you are on your hands and knees almost rock climbing up this cliff to get to the top of the ridge, where the arête begins and stretches out into the valley. But don't worry about it, push on, you can get through. It's really fun and exciting. You can mainly follow the polished rock, which shows where other hikers have gone before you. But one of the fun things about scrambling is that you kind of make your own way up the cliff and you find your way to the top yourself. So that's almost part of the excitement about it. Once you get to the top, you will then see the arête of Cribgoch stretching all the way towards Mount Snowdon in front of you. And that's pretty obvious where to go, because there's only really space for one person and 2 feet along parts of the ridge. So you can't really get lost. And you keep following this, you push on until you reach, excuse the poor Welsh pronunciation, Bwlch Coch, 858 meters. And then you'll reach the summit of Garned Ugain, which is 1,065 meters. And that is the peak that's opposite Snowdon. From there, you can see the Snowdon Mountain Railway and the other main hiking tracks leading up to the summit of Mount Snowdon. So you basically just need to rejoin with the path there. Summit Mount Snowdon, and then you can descend by any of the trails you so choose. Obviously, if you want to go back to the Penny Pass car park, then you're looking at the Miner's Trail or the Pig Track. You can also do the Horseshoe Loop, which will then rejoin with the Miner's Trail, but that's a pretty challenging hike, so if you're already tired from Cribgoch, it may not be worth it. The next thing I'm going to discuss is the Cribgoch hike safe? I would have to say it's the most challenging ascent up Mount Snowdon, which is already a pretty difficult mountain due to the temperamental weather conditions that sweep off the Irish Sea and often hit Snowdonia with mist, fog, rain, ice, you know, as I mentioned at the start, all the conditions I faced. The difficulty with Cribgoch is that it's extremely exposed and narrow, and there aren't many opportunities to turn back, and actually it can be harder to turn back once you are already on it. There's no sort of support system up there, and unfortunately accidents do happen and they can be fatal. So you need to make sure you're an experienced hiker or you're comfortable hiking and you know what you're doing. You can't be a complete novice doing this hike, because there's a lot at risk. Some of the things you definitely want to avoid are mist or cloud, because that could make the ridge completely hidden and that makes it very dangerous for you. You also want to avoid rain and snow and ice, mainly because if the rock is wet, then you could be in real trouble of slipping. And you also want to avoid high winds, because the updrafts and the crosswinds can knock you off the ridge. It's that exposed. You want to really go for bluebird days, perfect summer days if you can. Obviously it's more busy then, but that's the best time to hike it. If you're gonna hike it in bad weather or in winter, you really need to have mountaineering gear. It's you know, it's not something that you should take lightly. A good tip is just to keep checking the weather in the days before your hike, and maybe when you get to the visitor center, you can ask, is it safe to summit today? And they'll let you know. You can also, there's a little board which shows you what the weather is like up on the mountain, so you should just check that out and just be responsible. And you know, when I was hiking it with my friend, we were considering all the way up whether or not we'd have to turn back, because there'd been some snow and we just wanted to make sure the rock was dry. Fortunately, when we got to the top, it was dry, so we could continue, but you just want to bear that in mind that if it's wet, then this could be a really difficult situation. So what route do I recommend to hike Cribgoch? I was hoping to do a 12.5 kilometer hike, but as I mentioned, unfortunately, I had to add on those 3 kilometers. So it's more like 15 kilometers in total. And that was because I started from the car park down the road, walked up to Penny Pass, followed the pig track, then went up Cribgoch all the way up to Mount Snowdon. And then I went back down via the Miner's Trail to the Penny Pass car park and then onto my car park. That took about 7 hours, so it was a pretty challenging hike and we weren't really resting a lot, so it was quite a long day. I would say the Miner's Track is probably not the most interesting return journey hike you can do. I think after you've done Cribgoch, you're tired and it's nice to have an easy walk down, but I'd say do the Pig Track on the way down as well, because it goes along the side of the valley and it's just a bit more interesting, to be honest. And what should you pack for the Cribgoch hike? You want to be prepared for the bad weather. So you want to have waterproof trousers and a waterproof jacket. Unfortunately, I didn't have waterproof trousers and I regretted that quite badly. And that was when the weather wasn't even particularly awful. It was drizzling a bit, but it was certainly not terrible. And I was still quite nervous that I was gonna get soaking wet on my legs. So make sure you bring both of those. Also, probably you want a hat and gloves because it is pretty cold on that ridge. The big question of what you should bring is hiking boots or trail running shoes. I've done another video of this, which I'll link below, but I used trail running shoes, as did my two friends. And for us, we like to be nimble and light on our feet and skipping over the rocks, and that was perfect. However, you may be more comfortable with ankle support and hiking boots. When you're going over the screen, there's a lot of loose rock and you don't want to be twisting your ankles. So really go for what suits you best, but just make sure it's footwear that you're comfortable with. And bring in your bag, some extra water and some snacks for the trek, because you're not going to be able to stop anywhere. There is a cafe at the bottom, and there's actually a cafe right at the top of Mount Snowdon. But in between, that is a long stretch when you're going to need some fuel. So you want to bring your own stuff, but don't carry too big a bag because you don't want to throw yourself off balance. You really want to be as light as possible. And so yeah, thanks for watching, guys. That's pretty much everything with how you're going to do this hike. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please let me know below your thoughts if you've done this or if you recommend any other hikes like this, and I'll try and get back to you. I'm going to also be posting a travel guide of this, as I always do on my website, so look out for that if you're looking for a bit more information. And until then, please like and subscribe if you've enjoyed the video, because it helps support my channel. So thank you, guys.